Hello, today I am going to be doing something a little bit different. I am going to be reacting to all the boys I've loved before, three, always and forever. I have read all three of the books and I've seen all three of the movies. This is my second time watching it, so I have watched it before, but all the movies I've watched before, that's not funny. But yeah, I read all the books and I loved them. I loved the first movie so much. The second one I did not like, and this one I think is coming in at second. I think I like it better than the second one, but yeah, so I'm gonna be reacting to it today. This movie is all about romance, so I thought I'd wear earrings of the most epic romance of my life, which is Frog and Toad, just to get into that romance spirit. So let's get started.
Is spending time with my sisters.
Yeah, this is definitely pre-pandemic. Stanford, yeah, in the book, they don't live in Portland. They live in Virginia, somewhere in Virginia. So,
hi.
The colleges they're looking at are like UNC.
Campus is huge. Just wait until you see the library.
You went to the library for me?
Yeah, you know, sometimes I read books that don't have pictures cut. The lacrosse team is tough, though.
Someone went to the library for me?
Well, you wouldn't have gotten a scholarship.
You're like 16 hours ahead there. Come on, tell me what Friday's gonna be like. I promise I won't disrupt the timeline.
Well, it'll start off touristy, and then it'll get really fun.
You never think you're gonna disrupt the timeline, and then you disrupt the timeline.
I think the waiting might actually kill me.
I remember that feeling.
Guys.
Of course, Lara Jean found it. Makes sense.
Hi.
I was really hoping Kitty was gonna get a girlfriend in this movie. Did they get a driver? All right, gynecologist money. Heck yeah.
Bye, Tree.
She approves of the glitter.
I'm literally embarrassed at myself at how much I simped over him in the first movie. What does that mean, Lara Jean? All right.
True, or else you don't get your last present.
Sheet masks do not hurt. What is he doing? I don't even think I would have noticed that if they hadn't shown it on TikTok.
I got it. Wish we had a meet cute.
Well, it jumped my bones at the high school track. That was pretty cute.
I don't think that's what that means, Peter.
In movies, love is...
In the book, they have the proposal, like, in the woods, and they're all there, and it's like a whole planned thing. But whatever, this is cute. This is more intimate. It's like, I don't know.
Everyone, marry me, written on the Jumbotron. Love is actually about the moments when you think no one is watching.
Oh, good.
What she said.
Trina's rad and hot. You bring my zit cream?
Bicon.
You are a chick. Okay, you got this. No matter what happens, it's gonna be fine.
I feel the stress so much.
Everything is completely and totally
fucked.
Ruined.
The first time I watched this, I was like, oh god, is she gonna start singing like in the second movie? God, no. I didn't realize my first time around this was Wannabe by the Spice Girls.
Please don't use this low moment in my life to campaign for NYU.
No, I'm just saying.
Fair.
Look, Stanford is not the only college in the world. I never thought I'd end up in Scotland, and I know that it isn't...
Well, I'm not like you, Marco. I don't want to be far away from my family.
I think she wanted to be far away from Josh.
There's a truth universally acknowledged.
Are they still doing this?
That a high school romance never lasts long distance in college.
Alright.
Yeah, everybody knows that. Just look at Josh and Marco.
We're not like them.
Then what are you so afraid of?
They're not like them. Like, Margot literally was like, peace, I just want to break up with you. Like, they didn't try, even. Like, she broke up with him before she left, like, months before. I think in the first movie, he did a couple goofy faces, and because we were new to the Noah Centineo charm, we were all like, ha. And then they were like, okay, let's just increase the number of goofy looks by like 40% every movie. And I think that's what they did here. They're like, we need as many images of him scrunching his nose and doing huge ass smiles and wiggling his body in weird ways, and that is what our audience wants. And they were wrong. Did he?
What are you doing?
Did he do all that in like 4 minutes?
I'm celebrating your first night as a cardinal. Come on, girl.
Where did he get all those stickers?
Maybe we'll keep looking.
Sister, so clear the table, slather some sauce on it, and go to town.
Gross.
Oh, Chris.
Does that mean I get to keep my tree hat?
Yes.
I'm sorry. Like, I actually think that was, like, a sweet reaction in some way. Like, he was like, how are you? He didn't, like, freak out. I don't know. Maybe my bar is, like, on the ground. But, like, I honestly think that was, like, an okay reaction to that. I don't know.
Back down from a dare, are you?
You better sleep with one eye open, Lucas.
Remember when he was Reggie in Riverdale for like a hot minute?
Because
I do.
Everyone gather. We'll be breaking into 3 tour groups today. Last names A through I, J through P, and R through Z. And before anyone bothers to ask, no switching groups. Any questions?
Yes. Can we please switch groups?
That's a big no.
Someone did that at my school. They would have been made fun of endlessly. Love a montage. I hate how this is supposed to be 2021. No one's going to Times Square without a mask in 2021. I really love Chris's flare pants here.
Is that Jen? Yeah, she's touring campus today.
It's Sage from Gossip Girl! Oh my god.
That's a great school, congrats.
It's Sage!
Sorry, Chris,
where's Nate?
You're probably so confused. Well, we're talking.
Nate, it's Sage, I thought you went to Columbia. First watched the movie, I took a very long shower and listened to the song like 40 times. It does bump, I have to say.
Yes.
He just orgasmed. Ew. Chris has some really good fits in this movie. Also, where is John Ambrose? I miss John Ambrose McLaren.
If I don't wear it, will I look back in?
I wish she would like go to NYU and he was there, and then they would fall in love, and she'd be like, "Bye, Peter."
Or 10 or 20 years, and wonder if I made the wrong choice. I mean, how am I supposed to know?
Hey, remember when she like posted a video of you making out with a boy all over the internet? Remember that? That was crazy.
Oh my god, cute shoe.
But whatever, college buddies.
I like those things.
Oh, the parallel to the first episode, for the first movie with the shoes. Good one, good one.
What's up?
I think it's also in the exact same part of the hallway as the first movie when they had the shoe thing.
Sorry.
I'm sorry, like, her hair.
Not if I could.
It's not terrible, but I feel like they kind of did her dirty a little.
What 3,000 miles is gonna do to us?
No, we don't.
Yeah, we do. Otherwise, you wouldn't have made me this.
He got a point.
Something to remember us by.
He got a point.
You're saying.
If my partner gave me something to remember us by, I'd be like, what the fuck are you even talking about? Oh no. That would not be a good sign to me. Kitty's rocking that tux. She looks the best, I'm serious.
Something memorable?
It matters not what you've done, but what you do with what you've done for others. Hags, Peter.
And before I go, I just want to say, it matters not what you've done, but what you do with what you've done for others. Thank you.
Is that it?
Here it is. My memory of the first time I met you, or in front of me, and your name was written on your backpack.
In case she forgets.
Principal Cho called you up on stage.
That's the author. She has a cameo in every movie. I think that's cute. Jenny Han.
And a summer song in my chest. I didn't know hearts could do that.
It's that perfect attendance. Turn on. I'm sorry, I got perfect attendance my whole life and no really hot guys were coming after me, taking my hair out of chairs.
Sometimes I can't believe how lucky I am that you chose me. We've been through so much together, Lara Jean, and I never should have doubted that we'd get through this too. But I got scared, and I hurt you. I'm so, so sorry.
I know they do this on purpose just for people like me, but I'm a sucker for, like, in the last movie when they have all, like, the flashbacks and stuff, that always gets me. They know their audience, and it's me. I think I was sobbing at this point.
I will love you, Lara Jean. Always and forever.
He can spell!
Hi.
That's, like, kind of creepy. Like, if this happened to me in real life, I'd be like, where were you hiding? Like, what were you doing? And if he said, like, hey, behind me, I would have shit my pants. Okay, you know what I wanted there? Even though it would have been so cheesy, I kind of expected that, like, her hair would get caught somehow and Peter would be right behind her. Like, you know? But I guess that doesn't work alphabetically. And also, I don't know, maybe that's a little too cheesy, but that seems like a full circle moment, I guess. They pronounced my last name wrong at my high school graduation. Another random thing about my high school graduation, although no one cares, is that several people passed out due to the heat because it was outside and it was like on the news. People had to go to the hospital, so this is pretty momentous. I wish we had more of Lucas in this movie. So pretty.
Senior graduating class of 2021.
Did they have to make it 2021? Like, that's just an ouch.
Boy meets girl.
I just can't believe that Jen is, like, with them. Like, do you not remember when she leaked your almost sex tape? I can't. Where's John Ambrose?
Because life is-
Josh wasn't even in this movie either. Like, they mentioned him once and that was, like, it.
Beautiful and messy and never goes according to plan. And the truth is, I have-
In this book, like, I think she runs into either Josh or John Ambrose at a party and he, like, has a new girlfriend or something. So, like, you get more of a satisfaction ending with that. He gets, like, more wrapped up. But in here, they were just like, never mind.
No idea what it has.
That's such a pretty picture.
But I do know that love real love is choosing each other through all of it, every single day, beginning and middle and end.
Okay, we get it.
I know what most people are thinking. Two kids, 3,000 miles apart for 4 years? No way. You'll never make it. But we're not like those other couples. We are Lara Jean and Peter. And besides, you know one thing 3,000 miles is good for? Writing love letters.
Cute. There was too much lip biting in this movie. I feel like in the second movie, I recognized it immediately, like they went on their first date, and the number of times she was biting her lip, like in not like a sensual way, just was supposed to show like she was like shy and like contemplating things, and they did it even more in this movie. I guess they like, as the movies went on, they were like, okay, then the percentage of Peter cringing, doing really cringy, really expressive emoticon faces has to go up like 50% per movie. And Lara Jean has to bite her lip with a similar increase throughout the movies. I guess it's showing that he's getting more quirky and she's getting more horny. But yeah, I really love these movies. They're like comfort movies for me. I think they're really sweet. The second one I try to avoid because I honestly did not like it at all. Except for John Ambrose, he stole the show, and I wished he was in this movie, but unfortunately he did not grace us with his presence. But anyway, thank you for watching. Remember, it's not what you've done. It's what you do with what you've done for others, and I think we all need to remember that, so.